I've been in practice since way back in 1993. I've got a couple of families of four generations in my practice. Truly, cradle to grave medicine. So, despite everything, still obviously love what I do. But I can say it's probably the hardest time to be a family physician in a lot of ways now. It's become a challenge for sure in terms of the demands, the complexity of people's problems, and then of course the financial burden, I think that family medicine has become. Perhaps maybe a misconception out there around a couple of things. So our fees as family physicians have kind of been fairly stagnant, right? And when you come in and see us, you're coming in for your cold or you're coming in for your congestive heart failure. I get my $38, and with that $38, I have to pay my rent, pay my staff, pay my phones, pay for my computer system, keep the lights on, support my family, and pay my bills. So, and the cost of everything else, you have to physically see more people in order to keep the doors open. But there's only so much time in the day. My typical day is, I get to work at 8:30. I leave after 6. I come home, have some food, and then I sit down and do charts. Because the other part of this whole job that people forget is how much record keeping and form filling outing that there is. It's just that the burden is getting excessive. And I really love what I do, and I'm going to keep doing it, as I've assured my patients many times, because everyone's wondering. But it's so hard. I'm pretty tired. Those forms that we're filling out are not covered by any sort of fee code. There's some serious catch up that needs to happen, right? It's just, yeah.
It's
And
been
it's just
stagnant,
not
right?
sustainable. And if I was a medical student now, and I was looking at, like all the specialties that exist, and I looked at that particular piece, and for the hard work that's put in, right? I think we've been a little bit undervalued for a long time. So I've just renewed my lease this last year, and I had to do some real serious soul searching about, like, is this sustainable? On my own. I know this sounds sad, and I would hope maybe my patients wouldn't take this in the wrong way. But I probably would have retired 5 years ago in good conscience. If I had the back of whoever I was talking to, and all selfishness aside of hopefully having somebody to actually hand my practice over to eventually, it's really tough to advise medical students or residents to think about this life.
The situation sits right now, it's just no longer viable. Is that fair to say?
Pretty much, yes, I would say that is true. And I mean, not without a lot of sacrifice and self-sacrifice, right? So
Right.
thank you, Paul. Really appreciate it.
Okay. Nice to meet you this way too. So
Yeah, you
thanks.
too.